So I'll tell you a little story. So about a year ago, Fabian and me and Matthias from SoundCloud met, and we were asking him, you're really good at monitoring Kubernetes with Prometheus. You've been like the person with the most experience. What's missing in this space? And Matthias said that many times whenever he troubleshoots something, or in general, he would like to alert on the things that he sees through kubectl. So basically, he wants to alert and discover things that are cluster state rather than individual white box monitoring components. So the individual, not the individual Kubernetes components, but cluster state. We researched and we found this little tool called kubestatemetrix, which at the time had already existed under the Kubernetes organization. And it did something like this. So there's like a deployment manifest in Kubernetes, if you're familiar with that. If not, it's fine as well. Basically, you define, and that's exactly in the monitor that's not on, how many replicas you want of your application to be running. And it also gives you how many are actually running. So this information we get from the Kubernetes API. And we can turn that into Prometheus metrics. And that's exactly what this thing did. Turns out that there were actually only 4 metrics at this point. So, and at this point, the project had existed. It was actually started by Sam Gott. But it has been untouched for about half a year at this point. And we said, well, actually, why not maintain this? And we just picked up maintainership and worked on it a bunch. And suddenly, there was like this huge interest in this exporter, basically. And it grew really rapidly. And like loads of people are using it now. So fast forward to 1 year. So basically, this all happened pretty much exactly 1 year ago. So today, we have about 250 additional commits to last year, 77 more metrics, and around 40 contributors. Cool, but why do I actually talk about this? Well, a couple months ago, Google Cloud said we're actually super interested in this, and we would like to run this on GKE as well. But for that, we want you to make sure that all of this stuff is really consistent, so that all the metric names are consistent, and we want some stability guarantees, and most importantly, we want to load test this. And at that point, we were like, okay, I think we're pretty stable. Consistency, yeah, we can work on that, but it will break some things. But load test, we were kind of like, there's like this Go client for Kubernetes, and it does a bunch of caching, and we weren't quite sure how that would do. But it turns out it performs extremely well. So a couple people from Google were running some load tests, and this was like the spike of everything. This was the highest load, 1,000 nodes. That's huge. Not many people are actually running Kubernetes clusters this huge. And it only consumed 1 gigabyte of memory and 0.3 cores. So that's pretty awesome. And because we did all of this testing, we put all of this effort into this, and everything's consistent. So last week, we released kubestatemetrix 1.0. So if you're not already using it, go check it out. Have fun.